Toddlers are very conscious of space. They try to fit things into others, and they quickly realize when something doesn't fit. They might purposefully turn things around so they fit or look similar to other shapes in that environment. So in many ways, geometry is the first mathematical concept that a young child learns. An important and a very natural part in geometry is shape recognition. And as children interact with shapes, they start to realize that some shapes have common features. They also start to understand that shapes have names. It's equally or maybe even more important for them to recognize the attributes of a shape. For instance, corners, sides, number of sides. Initially, children describe a shape visually.
It is like a door.
But gradually they move away from this visual description to a more attribute-based description. And we want to encourage that.
How do you know?
It has three sides.
We want to make sure they have opportunities to interact with both two and three-dimensional objects, to recognize that they both have distinct features, that they have common features, and that a three-dimensional object is actually made up of several two-dimensional objects.
What part of it tells you that it's a triangle?
Three sides have a triangle.
Oh, a triangle has three sides.
We want to encourage children to change their perspective, to view things from a different orientation, and to gradually realize that a shape is a shape regardless of how it is placed. Children are naturally composing shapes in a variety of things that they do. When they are cleaning up and they're trying to put away things, they're kind of recognizing some shapes go with the others. In preschool, children experience composing shapes as an activity by itself, where they try to put together different shapes to compose a different one.
When we're in big square?
Yep.
There you go.
You did it.
Decomposing shapes is as useful as composing shapes because both of them help children to focus on the holistic shapes, the attributes, and how they all pull together.
Throughout the day, adults can raise children's awareness of shapes in their environment. Adults can provide materials that encourage exploration of shapes. For example, shape sorters for younger children and puzzles as they get older.
They're nice food. There you go.
Thanks. Knowledge of shapes can be reinforced through planned transition activities.
What color and what shape you have?
Green triangle.
Brooke got the green triangle.
Adults can talk to children about the shapes in their artwork.
So you made a circle, and a square, and a triangle, and then two circles.
It's important we help children identify the shapes by their names, but also that we probe them into explaining and thinking about the attributes of the shapes so they see the commonality between shapes. These experiences enhance their geometric thinking.